symbiotic nitrogen fixation. During the symbiotic nitrogen fixation, the symbiosis phenomena is found. The symbiosis found between the bacteria as well as leguminous plants. So that is the best example. So the type of bacteria is rhizobium bacteria. It is a rod shaped bacteria. Rhizobium bacteria is associated with legume plants by producing of nodules. Nodules are the tissue like structure. They consist nitrogenase enzyme as well as rhizobia bacteria and leg hemoglobin. Francia is another symbiotic nitrogen fixing bacteria, but it fixes the nitrogen in non-legume plants. It means it symbiont with non-leguminous plants, that is allnuts. Francia and allnuts are also association of symbiosis. The N2 fixing nodules are produced here, but here the plant is non-leguminous plants. How the nodules are produced? What nodule consists? The nodule consists number of bacteria and nitrogenase enzyme and leguminous leg hemoglobin, which promotes the nitrogen fixation. So, nodule formation, how the nodules are produced? You see here, this is the nodule formation. Here, this is the leguminous plant, the root of leguminous plant. Here, the root heads are penetrated into the soil, in the soil particles. In the soil particles, the free living bacteria is available. The rhizobium is free living bacteria. During the nodule formation, the first step is attraction. The root can attract the rhizobium bacteria. How? Means the root can secrete some chemical substances like amino acids, like sugars. They attract the bacterium towards the root heads. That is the attraction. After attraction, the bacteria are attached to the root cells. You see here soil particles, this is the root hair and these are the bacteria. When the substances are secreted by the root hair, the substances are surrounded at the root hair. There, the substances attract the bacteria. The bacteria come and joint onto the root hairs. After joining, the root hair shape is changed as hook-like for invading of rhizobium bacteria. The hook is produced. Through this hook, this is called infection thread.